Hi student, okay, today we will look into the chapter Managing Marketing Information. In business, managing information is very vital, very important. Why? Because the information will create opportunity for you to embark in new line of business. For me, information is wealth where we can make money. So that's why information in any field, any industry, any institution, information really important for us to make a decision, wise decision. Okay, so without a further ado, let us look into the learning outcome for this chapter. So basically after studying this chapter or listening to me, you should able to explain the importance of information to company. As define and explain the marketing information system and its components, explain the steps in marketing research process, describe how company analyze marketing information, discuss the issues in conducting marketing research, and this is chapter overview. So managing marketing information is divided to three main elements in this book. So we will look into marketing information system, marketing research, and marketing research issues. Okay, so for beginning, for you to understand more what is marketing information system, let us look into the terminology of marketing information system. So basically, a marketing information system encompasses people, equipment, producers, and policy to gather, short, evaluate, and distribute needed timely and accurate information to decision maker. An information system is concerned with the collection, storage, and analysis of information and data for decision making purpose. It is gathered from customer, competitor, and their product, and from the market itself. That's why I mentioned information is wealth. Actually, you can make money, profit, create opportunity when you are venturing in any type of business. Okay, marketer need a marketing information system to carry out their analysis, planning, implementation, and control responsibilities. The role of MIS is to access the manage the information needs, develop the needed information, and distribute that information in a timely manner. This information must be accurate and the latest, as it is vital for effective marketing decision making. MIS provide insights or information into marketing decision making with comprehensive and up-to-date information on both macro and micro environmental factors to businesses. Okay, here you can see a figure of marketing information model. So marketing information model is consists of sales data and customer information as the input. So this input will be short, and according to trends, and it will be labeled, and certain procedure will be applied. Then all this information will be analyzed as an output, and those output will be used in marketing decision making. And most of the marketing manager will use this information to produce a better advertising where it can easily reach the customer and consumer, and they also will improve the sales promotion method. So all this information from customer gathered to improve the marketing and selling strategies. Function of marketing information system in any business entity is simply to interact with marketing manager in determining their information needs. Marketing information system also builds information that is needed from internal database, information analysis, marketing intelligence, and marketing research. Manager analyze information before marketing information system distribute the useful information for the firm marketing activities. How to access information needs? There are four main sources of developing information. Okay, they are internal record, marketing intelligence, marketing research, and marketing decision support system. Internal records such as Nike would look at past sales of running shoes. Okay, so definitely they will record that information, so it can be derived from their sales report. Okay, marketing intelligence, the same Nike would attend trade shows, read industry trade journals, and talk to retailers to determine changes in the marketplace. That is called as a marketing intelligence. So marketing research, basically Nike would conduct a survey or run experiment to determine customer demand and its interest. It might use mail, telephone, personal or online surveys to gather data from its customer. So marketing decision support system help Nike analyze sales or retail data from its database and mine the data to see how a factor such as price, color or material can affect the sales. So these are the way to access marketing information. Marketing research is defined as a systematic design, collection, analysis and importing of data relevant to a specific marketing situation facing an organization. It is a formal study of specific situation aimed to enhance understanding and knowledge in explaining what and how things work. It can help marketer understand customer satisfaction and purchase behavior. It can help them access market potential and market share. It also can measure the effectiveness of pricing, product, distribution and promotion activities. Marketing means. Its finding provide guidelines in designing company marketing strategies. Okay, we will go through this marketing research process. These are the steps that involve in a marketing research process. Okay, first step will be on defining problem and research objective. Why we want to carry out this marketing research? Because when you want to do a marketing research or survey, it's involve a cost. So you have to like really make sure the objective of you to doing this marketing research. Then design the research plan. After designing, you have to implement the research plan, and the final result will be interpreting and reporting the finding from the marketing research. So how you will define the problem and research objective? Okay, understanding the marketing problem and developing research objective is crucial as it determines the research approach. In most cases, managers fail to identify and recognize the fundamental problem in their companies. A problem is a situation requiring some type of action, while a symptom is merely the evidence that a problem exists. When a problem statement is not defined correctly, the mistake can be costly to the firm. That's why earlier previously I mentioned we have to clearly understand why we undertake the marketing research, because it's involved when you're collecting primary data, it's involved a lot of cost. So better for you to minimize cost when you plan thoroughly, so we can reduce the costs that we're going to spend on getting the marketing information. Okay, there are three type of research method that we can carry out to collect marketing information. They are exploratory research, okay, where exploratory research focus to gain insight and discover ideas with the subject area rigorously for investigation at a later stage. Okay, for example, Apple intend to design the iPad in the best way possible and would like to find out what would make it less arduous, user friendly, controllable and modern for school children, which would eventually be accepted by parents and teachers. So this type of research called as exploratory research. Okay, second research will be on descriptive research, where descriptive research is examine further a problem than exploratory research through describing the characteristic of an issues, such as relationship between two variables. The research question normally begin with what, why, where, when and how in describing a problem. For example, Malaysia Airlines would like to investigate what are the factors that lead to customer loyalty towards airlines when making a purchase decision. Okay, this is a small example of descriptive research. The third and the last type of research is causal research, where it's trying to find the cause and effect relationship between two variables. It emphasizes on the effect of the independent variable if the independent variable increase or decrease. For example, Samsung would like to investigate if the massive recall of the new Galaxy Note 7 worldwide would result in a decrease of Samsung overall sales globally. So, this is the type of causal research. Okay. Okay, once when you already define the problem and research objective, then you have to design the research plan. Okay. A researcher need to decide whether to use primary data, secondary data or combination of two. For me, in business, we have to use both combination of two data, primary as well as secondary data. Primary data information collected for specific purpose at hand. Secondary data information that already exists or has been collected by a third party for another purpose. Typically, secondary data is used in the beginning to develop a plan for gathering primary data. Secondary data is used for exploratory purposes. How are you going to collect the data? What method are you going to use to collect the data? So, there are two methods. One is survey, one is non-survey. Survey normally is carried a questionnaire, mail, email, online, face-to-face or personal interaction are the ways to collect questionnaire. That is the way of collecting primary data. Whereas, survey also involve interviews through telephone, face-to-face interviews and online interviews. Okay. When talk about non-survey, non-survey is basically on observation, observe what is occurring or exists during the certain experiment. So, that is called non-survey. So, observation and experiment are under category of non-survey method. Sampling design is important because we cannot survey the whole population again because it's regards to the cost. Okay, so we normally take a sample. Okay, designing the sample required three decisions. Who is to be surveyed? Okay, the sampling unit. How many people should be surveyed? Okay, to represent the whole population. And how should people in the sample be chosen? The sampling procedure. Okay. So, sampling, there is two type of sampling, probability and non-probability. Under probability, we have symbol random, stratified and cluster, and non-probability, we have convenient judgmental quota type of sampling. Okay, then what instrument that we are going to use to collect the information? Okay, definitely questionnaire to collect the primary data and certain devices, okay, to collect, will be used to collect the needed information. So, after design, you have to implement what you design. What is your research plan? So, for implementing, it involves collecting, processing and analyzing the information. The data collection phase of marketing research process is generally the most expensive and the most subject to error. So, the researcher then tabulate the result and compute average and other statistical measures. Interpreting and reporting the finding, researcher present important findings that are useful in the major decision faced by management. In many cases, finding can be interpreted in different ways and discussion between researchers and manager will help point to the best interpretation. Here, marketing research role, descriptive roles normally divided into two. One is for predictive role, the second one will be a diagnostic role. Okay. Okay, marketing research, when you doing carry out any research, there is several issue. Okay, the beginning I already mentioned that the main issue is on the finance part. You have to carry out a survey and there is a cost element. Okay, so here in this book they stated three main issues. One is marketing research in small businesses and non-profit organization. Again, we are not sure do they have the fund, enough fund to carry out the marketing research or not. Okay, and international marketing research. Okay, the second issue will be international marketing research, and third will be public policy and ethics in marketing research. These are the main three issues discussed in this book. Thank you for your time and listening. If you have any question, be free to place it in our OCW platform. I see you in next chapter. Take care. Good luck.